The family of a young girl killed as she was being airlifted to the hospital is now taking legal action. CBS 2's Derek Blakely takes a look at the complaint against Air Angels.
Rob and Brooke Blockinger believe Air Angels, the helicopter medevac company hired to save the life of their 14-month-old daughter, Kirsten, was instead responsible for causing her death.
This accident that took her life and those of others on that helicopter was a totally preventable occurrence.
Last October, as Kirsten suffered a severe seizure, Air Angels was flying her from Sandwich, Illinois to Children's Memorial Hospital when their Bell helicopter hit a 700-foot radio tower and crashed in Aurora. The pilot and crew of two died, as did Kirsten.
We love Kirsten and celebrate her life, however short.
But the lawsuit charges Air Angels failed to follow measures urged by the National Transportation Safety Board for medical rescue helicopters, including installation of electronic warning systems and the use of two pilots.
A two-member crew would have greatly reduced the likelihood of this ever taking place. You have someone that's flying, have to take care of a map, have to do radio communications. It can be an overloaded work environment in a life and death situation.
What's more, the lawsuit says pilot Dale Waugh, who died in the crash, was suffering personal problems that should have been taken into account.
In this case, we had a 69-year-old pilot flying at night who had some personal stress issues with the divorce.
In 2008 alone, 28 people died in 7 helicopter medevac crashes nationwide, and in recent years, the industry has grown rapidly. But the NTSB's safety guidelines haven't been made mandatory by the FAA. Former NTSB Director Jim Hall says the choppers are regulated by a second-class system of safety.
You're putting at risk, highly trained professional lifesavers that are putting their lives at risk to save other lives.
Air Angels released a statement declining comment on the lawsuit until they can review it. Robert and Brooke Blockinger declined to speak at the news conference, but in February, they plan to travel to Washington for an FAA hearing on safety rules for the helicopter medical rescue industry. They hope the tragedy that they suffered will be a springboard toward tougher regulations. Reporting from the newsroom, Derek Blakely, CBS 2 News.
Thank you.